teacher explains the human body to 10-year-olds. All right, everyone, settle down, Mrs. Harris said as the students filed into the classroom, eager to learn. It was a sunny morning, and today was the day they would explore the fascinating world of the human body. Today, we're going to talk about how our bodies work and all the incredible parts that make us who we are, she began with a warm smile. So, can anyone tell me what the most important thing in your body is? Mia raised her hand eagerly. The heart. Exactly, Mia. Mrs. Harris nodded. The heart is an essential organ. It pumps blood throughout our body to give us energy. The heart beats about 100,000 times a day, and it's located in the middle of your chest, slightly to the left. Leo looked curious. But how does the heart know how fast to beat? Great question, Leo. Mrs. Harris continued. Your heart has a natural rhythm, and it speeds up or slows down depending on what you're doing. If you're running or playing, your heart beats faster to give you more energy. When you're resting, it slows down. Mia, always full of energy, jumped in. What about our lungs? I know they help us breathe. That's right, Mrs. Harris said, pointing to a diagram of the body on the board. Our lungs are in our chest, and their job is to bring oxygen into our body and get rid of carbon dioxide, which we don't need. When you breathe in, the oxygen goes into your lungs, and when you breathe out, your lungs push the carbon dioxide out. The class nodded, fascinated by how their bodies worked. Mrs. Harris then moved on to the brain. Now, let's talk about the brain. The brain is like the boss of your body. It controls everything you do, from walking to thinking. It tells your heart to beat, your lungs to breathe, and helps you remember things. Can the brain get hurt? Leo asked with concern. Mrs. Harris nodded. Yes, it's important to protect your brain. That's why we wear helmets when we ride bikes or skate. A brain injury can be serious, so we always need to be careful. Now, let's talk about our muscles and bones, Mrs. Harris said, walking over to a skeleton model in the corner. Muscles help you move, and bones give your body structure. Your muscles are attached to your bones, and when they contract, they help you bend your arms and legs. Your bones, on the other hand, are strong and help protect your organs like your brain and heart. Mia raised her hand again. What's the largest bone in our body? Good question. The largest bone is your thigh bone, called the femur, Mrs. Harris said, pointing to the skeleton's leg. It's strong and helps support your body when you stand and walk. And what about our stomach? Leo asked. Your stomach is part of your digestive system, Mrs. Harris explained. When you eat food, it travels down to your stomach, where it's broken down into smaller parts that your body can use for energy. After that, the nutrients are absorbed by your intestines, and the rest is eliminated. The bell rang, signaling the end of class. Remember, Mrs. Harris concluded with a smile, your body is amazing. Every part of it works together to help you live and grow. Keep learning about it, and take care of it by eating healthy, exercising, and getting enough rest. The students left the classroom that day with a new appreciation for the incredible way their bodies functioned, feeling excited to explore even more about themselves. Please like and subscribe for more fun videos. Happy learning!